Note, the following video depicts a specific configuration of the notebook. The same removal and replacement procedures apply to all configurations of the notebook. Before you begin, remove the top cover, wireless module, and audio board. Removal. Important. Make careful note of the routing of all cables for later replacement. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the power button board ZIF connector and disconnect the power button board ribbon cable from the system board. Caution. Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the display panel cable ZIF connector and disconnect the display panel cable from the system board. Caution. Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and cable. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the touchscreen cable ZIF connector and disconnect the touchscreen cable from the system board. Caution. Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and cable. Disconnect the power connector cable from its connector on the system board. Important! Do not grasp the cables when disconnecting a cable from the connector. Apply even pressure on each side of the cable connector and pull directly away from the connector. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the primary storage drive ZIF connector and disconnect the primary storage drive ribbon cable from the system board. Caution! Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Disconnect the speaker cable from its connector on the system board. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the media card reader board ZIF connector and disconnect the media card reader board ribbon cable from the system board. Caution! Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Remove the 6 4mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the system board to the base enclosure. Lift the left edge of the system board off of the alignment pins and guide the external connectors out of the cutouts in the base enclosure. Remove the system board. Replacement. Note, before installing a new system board, remove the following from the old system board and install on the new system board. Heatsink. Tow the external connectors on the system board into the cutouts in the base enclosure and lower the system board onto its alignment pins. Caution! Ensure that all cables are free from being pinched between the system board and base enclosure. Replace the 6 4mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the system board to the base enclosure. Insert the media card reader board ribbon cable into the media card reader board ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution! Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Connect the speaker cable into its connector on the system board. Insert the primary storage drive ribbon cable into the primary storage drive ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution! Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Apply pressure to the length of the primary storage drive ribbon cable to adhere it to the system board. Connect the power connector cable into its connector on the system board. Insert the touchscreen cable into the touchscreen ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution! Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and cable. Insert the display panel cable into the display panel ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and cable. Insert the power button board ribbon cable into the power button board ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Important: after system board replacement, be sure to complete post-installation tasks as required that may include verifying functionality of the notebook, updating the BIOS, updating DMI and other settings, injecting Microsoft Windows 8 digital product keys.